Stephanie Petty, June 11, 2018, 10:26 a.m. Anthony Bourdain's mother is opening up about how she learned of the celebrity chef's death from apparent suicide on Friday. In a phone interview with Today, Gladys Bourdain revealed that she last spoke to her son, who she described as feisty and very talented, on Mother's Day. Gladys also shared that she learned of the tragic death from her younger son, Christopher. "There was never any sign something was wrong," she said. She hoped Anthony would be remembered as a lover of people of all kinds of didn't hide his true self. "He didn't disguise anything," she said. "He was who he was, and it was out there for everyone to see," speaking with the New York Times just hours after news of his death. Gladys said she had no indication that her child might have been thinking of suicide. "He is absolutely the last person in the world I would have ever dreamed would do something like this," she told the newspaper. On Friday, longtime friend and renowned chef Eric Ripert found the Anthony Bourdain, parts unknown host, unresponsive in his hotel room in France. Both were filming an upcoming episode of the CNN show. Gladys spoke to Ripert following her son's sudden death, and Ripert told her Tony had been in a dark mood these past couple of days. Gladys also shared she had no idea why her son might have decided to kill himself. "Money beyond his wildest dreams," she told the Times. "Success beyond his wildest dreams. He had everything." Anthony Bourdain and Eric Ripert. Nielsen Barnard. Get Anthony Bourdain and Eric Ripert. Ripert was in France with Anthony to film an upcoming episode of the award-winning show Anthony Bourdain, Parts Unknown. "Anthony was a dear friend," Ripert said in a statement to People. "He was an exceptional human being, so inspiring and generous. One of the great storytellers of our time who connected with so many. I wish him peace. My love and prayers are with his family, friends and loved ones." Anthony Bourdain. Slaven Slavic. Getty speaking with People. French prosecutor Christian de Roquigny previously said there was no evidence of violence in Bourdain's death. "Nothing suggested the involvement of a third person," Roquigny continued, adding that an autopsy is the priority as police in Colmar, France, continue investigating the TV host's death. "If you or someone you know is considering suicide, please contact the National Suicide Prevention Lifeline at 1-800-273-TALK 8255. Text HELP to the Crisis Text Line at 741-741 or go to suicidepreventionlifeline.org. You may like,